I'm making a pulp mold. What else would I be making?
My name is Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making.
In order for us to make a pulp mold, we need to understand how pulp products are actually made. So let's take a look at how one of these products is manufactured to see what we can figure out so we can duplicate that process. It's very common for products to be molded in a horizontal fashion, just like this, and folded up. So this is very much in line with the way the charger is designed.
If you take a look at a pulp molded product, you'll see that one side is smooth and one side is rough. The smooth side is the side that's molded in the mold, and the rough side is the side that's face up. Do you see the texture in the part here? This is from the stainless steel screen mesh that makes the mold that they use to make this part. And this is what we want to make our mold like. Pulp molded products are chopped up cardboard mixed with water, placed into a mold to make a part. I've seen several other clever YouTubers make 3D printed molds to sandwich pulp in between the two molds to make 3D printed parts. The big drawback of this method is that it takes a long time for the parts to dry because the air can't get to the part to dry it out. In the previous video, you saw me create the data to make the 3D printed molds, which you can see are being printed here. I'm going to be using the 3D printed molds in a different kind of way. I want to make some actual screens that are more like the production process. As I often do to start any project, I'll do a sketch so I can visualize what it is that I'm going to be making to get an idea of what it's going to look like. The first part I make is going to be the back support for the wireless charger. I lay it out on a piece of paper and I'm going to use this as my template to cut out some brass screen. I happen to have a roll of brass screen laying around, and it's perfect for this project as it won't oxidize when it's exposed to the water, and it should be great for this application. Let's spray mount our template onto the brass screen and then just cut it out with some scissors. Alternatively, I think you could probably get away with like a copper screen. That would probably work as well. I would stay away from the steel screen if you're gonna make a mold like this. I use a hammer to help flatten out the surface and get a good flat piece before I use my 3D printed molds to crash form the part. Yes, this is what I'm using the 3D printed molds for, is to form the brass screen. I'm going to use my Heiko soldering iron here, and this has been a really great upgrade. If you want to get a good soldering iron, I can recommend this unit right here, but this makes a huge difference when you're soldering to actually have a good soldering iron. I'm using some flux and some solder here. The flux really helps the solder flow and it makes things quite a bit easier. Of course, having a soldering iron that generates some decent heat really makes the job a lot easier. I'm trying not to get too blobby of the solder on the brass. Sometimes it works better than others. Sometimes it gets clogged up in the screen. Ultimately, it's really not going to matter. Next, I'm going to cut out a frame that goes around the brass base piece that I just made. This will help stabilize it, keep it flat and straight before it gets joined to the other pieces and help in the final assembly. I lay my paper template on top of the brass screen, and here I'm using a knife to score cut the brass. It works pretty good, but I didn't cut it the right size. Damn. All right, I remake the frame. This time, I'll cut it to the right size. I score cut it. That works well. And we'll solder the part into place. Something that works really well is taking a little piece of the brass wire and almost like sewing the part into the frame, and this helps hold it together and in place in the right spot so that I can solder the two pieces together. Next, I'm going to make the base of the wireless charger. This is the part that sits flat on the table and where the last piece slides into to be all connected together. Again, I've made a paper template and I've used that to cut out my brass screen. I'm going to use my 3D printed molds to press form the brass into the correct shape. I don't have a hydraulic press or anything like that, so I'm just using some clamps to clamp the two halves of the 3D printed molds together, crash form, and make my brass screen into the nice form that I want. I use a ruler here to bend along one of the other creases just a little bit more, and then I use the 3D printed mold to help make sure that I have the angles the way they're supposed to be. Let's cut the side pieces so that we can attach them to the part that we just crash formed. Again, I have some simple paper templates and I use that to cut the side pieces so now that I can solder them in place to the formed part to get our base. I try to get the parts together as best I can, and I even pre-tin the brass and I wire it up, kind of sewing it just like I did before to get the parts together in exactly the right spot, and then come back with my solder and put everything together. The last mold to make is the front. This is the surface where the phone leans against and where the wireless charging element will be placed on the backside of the pulp product. This is by far the most complex, and 3D modeling this was extremely helpful in figuring out the dimensions and the tolerances and figuring out how big to make the molds and taking into account, of course, the thickness of the pulp and how big everything had to be so that when we do mold the part, it's going to fit correctly and hold the wireless charger in place securely. I cut a thin little cone here, and this becomes the slanted back part that holds the wireless charger. This is pretty tricky to solder all together. I actually needed an extra pair of hands to help me do that. And all the other parts are sort of cut by hand and then fit into the 3D printed mold. And here I need Wyatt to hold the parts down so that I can solder them correctly. Again, 3D printed molds are just invaluable for getting all the pieces to the right size and to fit together correctly and have the right dimensions so that when we mold this, the part comes out accurately. All right, this was by far the hardest part to make. Lots of soldering, lots of pieces fitting together, but it's really starting to come together and look nice. Put the side supports on. Soon we are going to be able to assemble the final mold. Just as a reminder, if you haven't seen the Team C's hashtag from the other YouTubers, we're trying to raise $30 million to remove 30 million pounds of plastic from the world's oceans. Head on over to teamseas.org to make your donation. Link in the description below. This is the part where I take the three molds and I place them together in the correct orientation, in the right order, and put them together to make one big mold. I've cut off the excess material so I can put them together at the hinge points, and I solder them into one big sheet. You'll notice I'm using a Kato exhaust fan, and this is pretty important when you're soldering. It really helps draw the fumes away from your face. Let's use some brass rod to make a frame to put all these parts together. This will stiffen up all the wire, make everything flat, and be nice and stiff so that when we go to pick up our pulp, we have a solid structure. The frame is essential because the pulp with the water is going to be pretty heavy and put a big stress on the screen, and we want that to be structurally sound so that we can get a good flat straight part. to trim everything off now that it's all soldered together. It's not the prettiest thing, but there's lots of area for the water to drain and for the air to dry the pulp once the part has been cast.
In the next video, we're just gonna pulp up some cardboard with some water. We're gonna use the wire screen from this video to make some prototype wireless chargers.
Make sure you give the video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already done so. Make sure to hit the bell so you get notifications every time I have a new video. Also, don't forget to follow me on social media. I'm on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Links in the description below and on the channel page. Rock on. Don't forget to check out the t-shirts and hoodies in the merch shelf below. Click here to check out some of the other design and making videos that I have that you might enjoy.